Trump phenomenon. I was wondering if you could expand a little on that and tell us some of the long-term consequences we will have if Trump is indeed put in office.
If Trump is in office?
Yes, sir.
Well, first we have to ask whether he means what he's saying. I don't know him, you know. I assume that he means what he's saying. If he does, not only we, but the human species is in very deep trouble. I'll come back again to global warming. That is a hugely significant phenomenon. I mean, we're now in a situation where the warming of the planet is proceeding at a level about maybe 100, some claim 1,000 times as high as anything in history that can be checked way back in early, long pre-human history. Nothing remotely like it. Sea level rise is now at a level beyond anything that's gone on for thousands of years. The effects of global warming are already extremely severe. Simply in destruction of species. Species destruction now is at the level of 65 million years ago when a huge asteroid hit the Earth, ended the age of the dinosaurs. Huge destruction of species. That's what's happening right now, and it's accelerating at the latitude where you and I live, roughly this temperate latitude. We are now moving south 10 meters a day just by the average effect of global warming, and that's going to accelerate. These are things with really lethal consequences. Now, what is the Republican Party doing? Trump in particular. There was a conference in Paris last December, an international conference, which tried to set some policies to prevent the global warming before it destroys us. It made some progress, not anywhere near enough, but the goal was to reach a treaty among the countries of the world where they would commit themselves to these measures, inadequate measures, but at least some. Couldn't be implemented. Very simple reason. The Republican Congress would not accept it. So therefore there's no treaty, just verbal commitments. Just a couple of weeks ago, the Republican majority on the Supreme Court sharply violated precedent to block measures, limited measures to reduce the extensive pollution from coal plants. Well, that's a message to the world, and that message is heard, saying don't bother doing anything because the United States is not going to allow it because of the Republican Party. Going back to Trump, he simply says it's not happening, so I'm not going to do anything about it. Now, that's quite apart from other policies he's advocated, some of which are really hair-raising. Like what he said about torture. He said, fine, let's torture people. In fact, the kind of torture that's outlawed by international law and became an international scandal, waterboarding, he says, that's the least of it. Let's do more. Let's keep all Muslims out of the country. Let's build a wall, or rather, let's get Mexico to build a wall to prevent people from fleeing into the United States. Now, where are they fleeing from, incidentally? Most of them from Central America, where they're fleeing from the results of our policies, which severely harmed Central America. No time to go to the details. And we go through the rest of it, it's pretty frightening. That's why the world is frightened. I mean, long before this, a couple of years before this, global opinion regarded the United States as the greatest threat to world peace. That's Gallup poll, American-run polls, show that the world has regarded the U.S. as the gravest threat to world peace by a large margin, incidentally. The Americans don't know about this because it wasn't reported here, though it should have been. Right now, the spectacle of the Republican primaries is frightening people around the world justifiably. The forces, you can kind of comprehend the reasons why people are flocking to Trump's banner. These are the classes of people for whom death rates, mortality is actually increasing. They see themselves as having their lives taken away from them, their dignity taken away, the possibilities for the future taken away. So they're rallying behind that banner. Things like that have happened before in the past, and as I mentioned, the outcomes were not pretty. So I think that's what we can fairly anticipate. Now, not entirely, because he's kind of a wild card. He says all sorts of things. Some of them make sense, some of them are crazy. It's hard to know what he means. But, you know, the U.S. is an extremely powerful state. To have somebody who's kind of a wild man with his finger on the button that could destroy the world, namely the nuclear weapons button, where it could make decisions of an enormous influence, I think is a very frightening prospect. Although, to want the truth, my own feeling is that his main competitor, Ted Cruz, is even more dangerous.